Here's something we can all agree on: the quest for unity. Even when you might view things a bit differently than others around you, there can still be a sense of unity in Christ. Bible helps you navigate some challenging topics and leads you to Jesus, the one who unites all believers and makes all things possible. Our world is broken, but Jesus is ready and willing to bring healing. Discover God's answers for your pain in the Bible. Power to embrace each new day. How you start the day matters. I remind you of God's truth with "What will Jesus do?" Despite what's happening in your life and in the world around you, Jesus is the source of power to keep you focused, confident, and at peace. Is your church of base? The love that takes grace alone conquers sin. Some people are grace-based, others are not. Some churches are grace-based, others are not. Every individual and every institution can be works-based by trying to use law and legalism to attain righteousness, in their own minds at least. But they don't normally advertise this. I have yet to see a sign that says, "Welcome to First Friendly Church of the Law. We will burn you out and out with a smile on your face." This week's sermon: self-righteousness through self-effort in 237 easy steps. No, it's much more subtle than that. Leave you with that feeling you aren't performing the way you should. The conclusions: God's not pleased and you are not righteous. The church in Galatia was a works-based church. That's why Paul wrote this to them: "I do not set aside the grace of God, for if righteousness could be gained through the law, Christ died for nothing." Antioch, on the other hand, was grace-based. The Lord's hand was with them, and a great number of people believed and turned to the Lord. News of this reached the church in Jerusalem, and they sent Barnabas to Antioch. When he arrived and saw what the grace of God had done, he was glad and encouraged them all to remain true to the Lord with all their hearts. Think about this for a second. A grace-based church is a family of believers who choose to live not by rules, but by the ruler. They live and live through Jesus and His grace. The focus is on Jesus and His grace, not the legalism on self. What is your focus today? Dear Lord, give me the discernment to recognize the voice of law and legalism around me. Be they coming from my church, my friends or family, or from my own flesh, give me the wisdom and the strength to be grace-based with myself and them too. Amen. Where are you in the picture of grace? Grace is given to heal the spiritually sick, not to decorate spiritual heroes. God gives us a lot of pictures of grace in the Bible, since it's not too cool to have real pictures in our Bibles anymore. God gives them to us in words to keep our attention and to help us see ourselves in His incredible story. Matthew 20 is one of those pictures. "For the kingdom of heaven is like a landowner who went out early in the morning to hire workers for his vineyard. He agreed to pay them a denarius for the day and sent them into his vineyard. Throughout the day, the landowner kept hiring people. It was almost beating went out again about noon and about 3 in the afternoon and did the same thing. About 5 in the afternoon, he went out and found still others standing around. So he finally gets everyone working just before the whistle blows. But when they heard to the time clock to punch out, something weird happens. The owner of the vineyard said to his foreman, "Call the workers and pay them their wages, beginning with the last ones hired and going on to the first." The workers who were hired about 5 in the afternoon came and each received a denarius. And they weren't even with a union or the government. Sorry, I couldn't resist. Understandably, the guys with the blisters on their hands were a little miffed when some of the others haven't even broken a sweat. But this story isn't about fairness, is it? It's about grace. Do you know the reason why we don't like this passage of scripture? But this story isn't about fairness, is it? It's about grace. Do you know that the reason why we don't like this passage of scripture? Because most of us instinctively identify, but do you know who are in this world picture? We are the 11th hour workers, that's who we are. O Lord of the vineyard, reveal my plans through your word. Humble me by your grace, amen. Where are you based? The great mistake made by most of the Lord's people is in hoping to discover in themselves that which is to be found in Christ alone. After decades of following Jesus and studying his life, I am still amazed at the graphic contrasts that set him apart from everything and everyone else. The contrast between love and grace is one of those black and white distinctions that scripture magnifies. Out of his fullness we have all received grace in place of grace already given. For the law was given through Moses, grace and truth came through Jesus Christ. No one has ever seen God but the one and only Son, who is his in closest relationship with the Father, has made him known. Amen. If you want to base your life on law, go with Moses. If you want to base it on grace, go with Jesus. You get to choose. It's one or the other, day by day. Law says God has people on performance-based acceptance and I must earn his acceptance. That means I must perform in order to earn his acceptance. If I perform well, he will be happy with me. If I don't perform well, he won't be. Grace says God has his people on a Jesus-based acceptance. Because Christ is in me, I am fully accepted. I just need to know, appreciate, own, and enjoy that acceptance. A grace-based person completely in Christ and his work. But be warned, the evil one will use anything to deceive you, even a scripture. Remember, Satan tried to use the scripture to tempt Jesus. He loves to see Christians live out of the flesh, and he knows that the flesh and the law go together. So he loves getting you focused on rules, because he knows that law, flesh, and rules lead to death and despondency. Since Satan has lost you to grace, he'd love to keep you wallowing in love, and he will deceive you any way he can, even using biblical commands to get you to live out love by your flesh, live through you by grace. God of grace, I refuse to let Satan put me on the performance-based law. Please show me when I fall for this deception. Make all my decisions of obedience based on grace as a natural overflow of your complete acceptance of me in Christ. Amen. You and Mephibosheth. To the extent that you are clinging to any vestige of self-righteousness or are putting any confidence in your own spiritual attainments, to that degree you are not living by the grace of God in your life. Mephibosheth. No, I didn't just sneeze. That's a name. It's a guy in Bible. He's one of my favorite biblical characters, partly because I love his name so much. Mephibosheth was the son of Jonathan and the grandson of King Saul, who hated David with a passion. When Saul and Jonathan were killed in the same battle, news got back to the nurse who was taking care of Mephibosheth. He was 5 years old at that time, and she started to run for fear. She grabbed up the little boy. She tripped. She fell. She landed on top of the boy, and she crippled both of his feet. When David eventually ascended to the throne, he had Mephibosheth brought before him. I'm guessing that Mephibosheth was pretty sure he was toast. He was a direct descendant of a royal enemy, and David would likely squish him like a bug. But David didn't. David said to him, "I am going to show kindness to you. Because of your father Jonathan," Mephibosheth responded, "why would you show kindness to a dead dog like me?" This is a beautiful picture of God's grace. David represents God's giving grace and kindness. Jonathan represents Jesus Christ. Mephibosheth represents you and me. Though we are born in sin as descendants of the enemies of God, God shows us kindness because of Jesus. That's a picture of grace. Imagine you are Mephibosheth. Imagine that you are in this picture of grace because you are. Oh Lord, without you we are nothing more than dead dogs. In Jesus we are welcome to live in the palace in the presence of the King. Thank you for your grace, Heavenly Father. Amen.